This is Yamaha Rebuild. There you have it. Good morning. There she is. Main project for today is the license plate. By the way, these came out absolutely perfect. The blue is a test. We'll see how it looks. Worst case scenario, I'll paint them black like the between caps. Now I need to create more space between here for the license plate. I found these small ones. It fits perfectly. But you will get that look. One big, one small, and I don't like that. Two of the small ones is about 1.5 big one. So I'm gonna measure two big ones next to three small ones. Whichever is longer will go back, whichever is shorter go front. Give the exhaust a small angle, which will create space for the license plate down here. So this what I'm gonna do first. Then we're gonna lower everything down, because the bike is at an angle now. So when everything is straightened up, the backside will rise, which gives me a more accurate look at the light and the license plate holder. Then I want to clean out this mess. I got the electric tape. So we're gonna make that all fancy so we can install the front, if there's still time today. I'm a little bit troubled with time today, because I spent an hour and a half searching for bolts that were long enough and would fit those caps. These are M8s, I found M6. You have to do a little play around, but in the end, most likely, I will replace them with Pro bolts anyway. So the timbers are a little bit shorter, just a little bit. There it is, very weakly. I'm gonna tighten it a little bit more. For those people who think, well, tapering down towards the end might not sound logical, these are the original ones. As you can see, there's a height difference as well. Quite a big one. So keeping them angled is probably even the better thing to do. Okay, this is how it is now. Still need to tighten those, but that's how it is. Bike is on the ground. So it looks absolutely perfect straight. Spaces give me enough room on both sides. I got these two pieces of steel. I don't have a welder set enough, but I can fit this one in here. Screw holes to hold it in place. Cut it out. Bend it. Screw this one on there with the same screw that holds the plate. Doing this one-handed, I'm sorry. And then it will give you that idea. One screw in the back. So that's what we're gonna try. I don't have a welder, that's why I'm doing it this way. Otherwise you should just weld it together. We have to improvise. That footage will be very shaky because you are standing on the same table I'm using as bench. So sorry for that. Perfect. Test fit. Okay, so now I can mark the corners, trim away excess metal, bend it, put the other part on it. We're getting somewhere. Bike will not be finished today, which is a downside because I didn't get my day off tomorrow. But for sure as well, I will get this part off and paint it. Managed to mark them. The insides. So this should give the perfect fit. I'm just gonna leave a little bit of room. On both sides. As you can see, this isn't the perfect cut. This is all really weird shaped. But it's hidden, so I'm fine. This needs to be straight. Or at least as straight as possible. Also not the best way to work. Thank God I'm not a professional. Because otherwise, Chinas would piss on me like shit. Test fitted it, cleaned out these sides, and I marked it. So you can, yeah, you can see it. That's where we're gonna bend it. So that's the line I'm gonna bend. So I'm strictly on it. Obviously, I can use the grinder to make a corner in it and make bending easier. I don't want to fuck it up. Believe it or not, it is absolutely perfect. Absolutely perfect. Skip the boring bit because, well, one is boring and two, no one better be. Center line this one. Align the center line, marked where the corners are. And then diagonal cuts, which I'm gonna make first. Chop that off. Then it will hold for both and for the number plates, which are already center lined as well. And then we can do the first trial fit. So it isn't perfectly even, but it looks all right. So many health and safety issues here. This isn't my best piece, but if I'm not a professional, most of this stuff I'm doing for the first time even, so made all the corners round except the two outer ones, but even the inner ones here are round, so it looks nice and shabby. There you have it. Measuring out this part to find the perfect place for the first hole. I hope you're a little bit clean. It's the visible side, so this will go on there like so. With the license plate, the hole needs to be between, a terrible line, I'm sorry, between these two lines. But this is the bottom of this, so I can't go too low. So I'm probably gonna do it there-ish. Enough meat there left. Center it, punch a hole, and get on with it. Absolutely perfect. drill a hole, measure it out, punch it, drill a hole. Then I can stick these two together. So I found these screws, focus, which is I prefer these above flathead or Phillips screw, because everybody owns a flathead or a Phillips screw. These are less common. 4 millimeters might be a bit smallish, but you can always go bigger. Centerline it until you're happy. Kind of shorten the bolt. One number plate holder. It fits absolutely perfect, man. Couldn't fit better. Making my own life a little bit more easy. Centerline, heightline. It's now properly glued together with a special metal glue. That way, hopefully, it will become one piece, one strong piece, which is what you need. I am, however, checking whether or not this is straight. While the two compound stuff is drying, I'm gonna center punch another hole, and it needs to be in this area. So we're gonna do it there. There. Let's recheck before I punch the hole in it. The good thing is I can now use this hole to center punch the other part. This is the old one. This piece apparently is also legally needed to be in. So we're gonna take it out. There are a few options below. One of them might be, although it doesn't seem to have the proper specs. I'm afraid using this is gonna block the light. I might do that because the center line is on the back. So I can just put this one through. Make sure that my hole is aligned with the center line. Always measure twice. This fits without blocking the lights. So we're gonna center point a new hole in the center there for this bolt. So we're gonna place the reflector there. This will also help that I put this piece of metal to the black piece instead of only the backlight screws. So it will be a more sturdy piece. That's why the center line helps. X marks the spot. Deburr it. The only downside is obviously this is going to be a bigger size, so I'm gonna find a bigger drill bit. There it is, how it looks at the moment. That's gonna be the look, nice and tight. Now we're gonna
remove that piece and then blemish it all together with lights. I think they might be brake lights, but more importantly, the white lights aren't blocked by the reflector and still shine onto the plate. Ugly as hell, but we're gonna clean it. Still quite asymmetrical, but it looks better. Finishing touches and done. Clean it, remove the bolt, spray paint it, primer, and black coating. Kinda said that I didn't get anything else done today, although I did fix the exhaust system, but that's part of this. But that is how it is. You know, I rather do it good than fast. Next, that's also my first time. So I made a hook that will give me as much freedom as I can have. There's gonna be two layers of the primer and a couple of layers of black. First layer of black. Okay, in between layers we're gonna make these a little bit shorter. So this is how you take that piece off and unscrew both bolts to keep the thread nice and clean. By undoing the nuts to clean the threads. Very quickly before the battery dies. I fuck the last layer up, but fuck it, that's the backside. There she is. I'm done for today. So next time is fixing the number plate, putting all the panels back together, fixing the last mirror and tightening that up, fixing the head plate, front protection, rear protection, battery, coolant leakage, fill it with more engine oil, and then we're ready to go. On to the next one.